Itasca is a remarkable environment.
Because we're sitting at this interesting ecotone between different biomes, there's implications for understanding how climate is going to impact these ecosystems. Minnesota is the land of 10,000 lakes. There's no shortage of aquatic habitat in Minnesota, but Itasca itself is very special because of the glacial history of this place and because it is a protected area.
The station really is meant for enabling science among people and community. You learn something in a classroom or in the field, but you revisit it all the time because you're immersed in it. 25% of the state of Minnesota's old growth forest is here, right here in the state park. That makes for very interesting biology. On top of that, we're situated near the headwaters of the largest river system in the United States and the Mississippi River.
We come for the river, but we return for the pines. And that's what a lot of our visitors always say. And some people have been coming for 60 years. Every year, there's over 500,000 visitors.
The station has its roots dating back to 1907. Students that came up for the first 20, 30 years really were forestry students.
The concept of forestry was new to this country. And so the work they had done not only helped these students become our future foresters, but the research and work they did is material we still use today in managing our park. By the 1930s, more students from the biological sciences were coming as well. And so additional research was being done, not only on the forest and the animals and the plants, but also on the lake study.
The people taking my class right now, it's a mycology class, field mycology, are studying mushrooms. There's a moment in most of these classes where the students realize that for certain parts of the learning, they're watching the professor or the instructor do things that are off script. And those are the best parts of these courses, I think, because it's a demonstration that the professor doesn't know everything, but they have learned the tools to figure out the answers, and they enjoy it.
The College of Biological Sciences offers a program called the Nature of Life, where every first-year student has the opportunity to come up to the field station and take a mini course for just a few days. It's part of their orientation process. It's a really unique opportunity for students to have access to a site like this that otherwise they wouldn't maybe even know about. Itasca is a fairly large research station. We have research laboratories that are well-equipped. We have spaces where people can just bring in messy samples and process them. We have lots of equipment that's accessible to researchers. We also have access to the lake. We're right on Lake Itasca. We have docks with boats. We have motorboats. We have canoes. So lots of ways to get out on the water as well. Itasca has a long history of research. A lot of the research that happens here is really basic science, trying to understand how systems work, how organisms work, what are their natural history characteristics.
We have people here working on dragonfly behavior to try to understand the physics of prey capture by dragonflies. We've had people focused on fire ecology.
The region in Minnesota is very unique because we are sitting at the convergence of three of North America's largest biomes. So we have the coniferous forest, we have the deciduous, and the prairie.
That makes for a remarkable place to do biology because you can access all of those. As things change with our climate, we want to understand how things might react or behave in a changing environment, and you can't predict that without knowing how they operate.
Itasca has a lot of long-term data sets that look at weather data or lake ice data and lake water quality data. And some of them date back into the early 1900s. So if you really want to, you can look into these data sets and start to see how things have been changing over time, which can really give some great perspective into what might be happening in this area as a result of climate change.
One of the wonderful opportunities of having the research station here in Itasca State Park is it allows us to work with the staff, sharing their work and their research with the park visitors, where we'll bring in a graduate research student or one of the professors, and we'll do a presentation for the public where they share the work that they are doing, and a lot of times it's hands-on.
We've realized that the science can only go so far if we're the only ones talking about it and if no one's listening. So the engagement is key.
Itasca is really special when it comes to our living and learning community. It gives you that experience of staying in the North Woods and making these really great friendships with the people that are up here who share a similar passion for biology.
Part of the future of this place involves opening the doors to others that would see the value of it. I think we're realizing that there are more people that see the value of this place and maybe have different perspectives that enrich those of the scientists. I think that includes social scientists, but also artists, local community members, and I think bringing them here as something like common ground is a way to enrich the experiences for all of us and probably to make the science itself better.